China is the birthplace of tea and origin of tea culture. Chinese people have a long history of drinking tea, traced back to the Qing and Han dynasties. The tea trend took off during the Tang dynasty in the 8th century, when it became China's national drink for the Han and ethnic minorities along the border areas. During the Tang dynasty, tea became a bestseller on the ancient Silk Road, traveling thousands of miles with camel caravans and sailing to all parts of the world. Originating in China, tea has become popular all over the world, and it comes in a wide range of styles. And so begins the legendary story of tea.
You cannot separate China with tea. China is tea. Tea is China.
This is the Dajingmen section of the Great Wall in Zhangjiakou City in North China's Hebei Province. Dajingmen is known as the Great Wall's most crucial gate. In ancient times, the main land routes for Chinese and foreign business communications were the Silk Road, the ancient Tea Horse Road, and the Zhangku Commercial Road. Among them, the Zhangku Commercial Road is known as the Steppe Silk Road and the Steppe Tea Road. Dajingmen is the starting point of such legendary business travel.
我们现在看到的这段长城呢，就是明长城。前面这个门就是被称为万里长城第一门的大京门。长城看的像是一条障碍，其实我们好多关口、好多的像大京门这样的门，都是为了沟通而设置的。万里茶道的茶叶从我们的武夷山出发。 陆续的用马匹、车辆一路北上，运到长城脚下，运到大京门脚下，穿越大京门出去，登上蒙古高原，穿越沙漠戈壁草原，到达欧洲。大京门开了以后呢，由于茶叶贸易的兴盛，云集了全国各地的商人。在大京门内外，当时商家店铺1500多家，还有40多家。
This magical leaf of the Orient soon claimed popularity in the West. Tea was first brought to Britain in the early 17th century by the East Indian Company. Drinking tea is entrenched in British way of life. Not surprisingly, Britain is one of the world's biggest tea consuming nations.
其实这片叶子啊，不仅来影响中国几千年的历史啊，同时把文明带到了西方。Over
time, milk was added. This might have softened the harsh and bitter flavors or reduced the temperature to prevent bone china teacups, which were commonly used at the time, from cracking. Many assume that adding milk to tea started in England, but that's not the case. The British didn't start drinking tea until the 17th century, whereas dairy may have been added to tea by ethnic Tibetans as early as 781 AD. Milk tea features a magnificent history of the exchange and fusion of China's agrarian and nomadic civilizations. Tea and milk, at the dietary level, represent the preferences and characteristics of the farming and nomadic cultures. During the Tang Dynasty, numerous dairy products were brought into then cosmopolitan city of Chang'an by the Hu people in the western region and the herdsmen in the north, experiencing a historic encounter with tea.
茶和奶的一个融合是中国多民族的一个交往、交流、交融过程的一个缩影。 在唐朝的时候，第一次实现了奶和茶的融合，后面呢就慢慢的变成奶茶，变成一个平民化的、大众化的一个过程，延续至今。The
latest trend among young people is the Chinese style milk tea, which offers a variety of unique ingredients like cream cheese and fruit.
it has quickly gained popularity as a tasty new drink option, even becoming a global phenomenon.
It's nice. I like it.
They have a lot of options. I think it's very, very refreshing, and I really love the extras, like the fruits inside. It's really good.
Like once a week. I love it. I really like the concept. I literally recommend it to everybody once, whoever's never had it before. So it's very innovative.
The sound of camel bells outside Da Jing Men was replaced with a new sound today. The first China-Europe freight train carrying tea departed from China in 2021. The train departed from Huangshan in East China's Anhui province and arrived in Tashkent, the capital of Uzbekistan. The Great Tea Road lives on today. Tea continues to bind China and the world.
我曾经是这样形容过茶叶和丝绸的，聪明智慧的中国人用一捧泥土两片树叶把中华文明奉献给了世界。一捧泥土就是我们的瓷土，两片树叶，一个是桑叶，一个就是茶叶。桑叶出现了丝绸，茶叶实现了沟通。
Centuries agoTea reigned as the most sought-after commodity along the Silk Road. Its impact extended far beyond the regions along it, reaching a global scale. It became a symbol of Chinese civilization, facilitating the fusion of Chinese culture with numerous others. Centuries have passed, yet tea's popularity continues, forging new chapters in its long history.